everybody, welcome to Wednesday of Super Bowl week. And of course, Super Bowl week means the Waste Management Phoenix Open, of course. And I'm back with another one of my PGA DFS top five videos. I've already given you the values and the sleepers here this week. And while I would love to let you know that Tom Brady would be a fade of mine this week, of course he's not a fade of mine. Who would I be if I was fading Tom Brady this week? The greatest quarterback ever to live, at least in my opinion. Of course, I'm repping the Tom Brady colors. It's where I live now, so don't call me a bandwagon fan. I just happen to be a Tom Brady fan that happens to live where he plays now. So let's get away from my football takes, as I guess the last one. I'm really excited to watch the game. Two greatest quarterbacks possibly ever to live showing down on Sunday. But before we get to Sunday, we get two, maybe three good rounds of golf. Hopefully we get three. Hopefully we get four good rounds of golf out of our golfers this week. Here are, though, the five fades of golfers that I hope we get bad performances this week from. And the first one is Harris English. Again, what a surprise. Here's the thing. The price isn't down to a respectable level where I'm comfortable paying. At $9,300, I just don't see it. I would much rather play Will Zalatoris. Even Scottie Scheffler, who doesn't seem to be playing that well right now, definitely more apt to play those guys. Course history, we got a 16th and a missed cut in his last two chances. Obviously, we had the missed cut there last week at the Farmers for Harris English. So off the tee, we know he's pretty consistent. 28th, his approach game is his worst part, 102nd. Around the green, he's 50th and 19th on the strokes gained putting. But coming in somewhere above 15% projected own. Again, I'll take the lower ownership with Scottie Scheffler. Maybe not so much with Will Zalatoris, as he's been creeping up quite a bit here this week. But still, somewhere above 15%, I am out. Second guy that I'm going to be fading here this week is Corey Connors, and a guy that I liked a lot last week, but I don't know that this course is a great fit for him. He obviously relishes in opportunities that rely on strong ball striking, hitting a lot of greens, that type of thing. This week, I think it's a little bit more of a scoring week. 45th last year, kind of where I expect him to be. Now, granted, does that mean he's a good value play, a good cash game play? Yeah, I think so. Just don't know that the upside is there at the Waste Management Phoenix Open for Corey Connors here this week. Just don't see it as a perfect fit. Again, 20th off the tee and 46th on the approach. Obviously super consistent. That's why I still feel he's good for some cash game formats. The next guy, though, that I'm going to be fading in GPP formats for the most part, and it's the second week in a row that I'm doing this, although he wasn't part of my fade group last week. Last week it was Xander Schauffele who came in second. I just keep trying to fade him and it doesn't work. But I did measure up to it with Harris English and my last fade there, Siwoo Kim. Both of those missed the cut. So I had two guys come in second, Schauffele and Palmer, while two guys missed English and Kim last week. So maybe that was not bad. Okay, now back to this week. Sorry. Golfer number three, Billy Horschel, 8,400. Listen, he's got decent course history, 9th and 39th here the last 2 years. But what I saw out of his game over the first three starts of his season was a heavy reliance on a decent off-the-tee game and a strong, strong reliance on the putter. His irons just aren't that good enough to compete here this week. As good as his putter is, I think he's an okay play. Again, at 10% owned in a GPP, I would rather go down to lower-owned guys or even up higher to some more lower-owned guys. Again, like Scottie Scheffler, maybe Zalatoris and the like. So again, Billy Horschel not in play for me this week. My fourth golfer that I'm going to fade is a guy that I have been behind quite a bit this start of early season, and it's Brendan Steele. 7,400 coming in at 10% owned. Did not play last week at the Farmers, but had a 21st at the Desert Classic, which I think is a great fit for him. However, here, course history, last 2 years, missed the cut. It's just not for me this week. $7,400, again, I think it's a little bit too expensive for Brendan Steele. If he was in the Dylan Fratelli range at 6,900, I think there'd be a big difference. But $500, $600 in salary, some may not think that that's that much. But hey, listen, it's Billy Horschel to Will Zalatoris, and I'll take Willie Z or Scottie Scheffler over Billy Horschel every day of the week. So I would rather save my monies, take Steele, go down to Fratelli, get a similar type player with similar type upside, and fade the mid-price chalk. He's not going to be terribly chalky, but still, I'll be certainly underweight Brendan Steele this week. And my last golfer that I'm going to be fading is Patton Kizzire. And again, a guy that I have played a decent amount early here in the season, especially at the Sony Open. But listen, I think the run is done. He doesn't have good history here. He came in 53rd 2 weeks ago at the Desert Classic. And I'm not really sure why people want to play him at 10% owned, just because maybe of the little bit of recent form. But still, a real heavy reliance on his putter. He's 26th in strokes gained putting this year, 64th around the green, 167 on the approach, and 74 off the tee. Which for him, granted, that is much better than what we've seen in years past. And certainly a good career resurgent for Pat Ngezhaire after maybe a down year or two. But not the spot for him here for me this week. So, all right, let's do a quick review. Harris English is my top fade. Corey Connors and Billy Horschel, my middle fades. And then my mid-price chalk fades this week are Brendan Steele and Pat Ngezhaire. So thank you all for joining my PGA DFS top five fade video of the week for the Waste Management Phoenix Open. Enjoy the Super Bowl. Enjoy the Waste Management Phoenix Open. It's a great sports weekend, possibly the best of the year in terms of overall sports weekend. Remember, I'm not talking about golf weekend, of course. I think anybody that is a true golf fan would choose the Masters over this week. But as a sports fan, you've got a bunch of stuff going down, so enjoy it. And if you're looking for more content for the Waste Management Phoenix Open, join Ben and I tonight, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to go live before lock. We're going to break all of it down, give our top plays, and so much more. So join us then. And of course, if you're looking for more videos, like and subscribe to our channel here so you can get notified right when we come live. So until next time, everybody, good luck this week at the Waste Management Phoenix Open. Good luck with your bets on the sports, on the Super Bowl. And of course, go Tom Brady and Rob Gronkowski for that matter. Cheers, everybody. See you next time.